my sleep is gone, my heart is full of sorrow. I can't believe how much I've let you down. I dread the pain that waits for me tomorrow. When the sun reveals my broken dreams scattered on.
Hey Crusaders, and welcome back to the channel. This video is going to be a little bit different, and from this video forward, it's probably going to dictate a lot of what this channel may be and our journey that's going to be from this point going forward. Saturday, we had a devastating loss. I'm going to back up a little bit because by the grace of God, I wasn't here. Friday, I was coming in from Michigan and got trapped in a freak snowstorm. And decided that I needed to get a hotel for the night in Michigan, and then I waited to late in the day on Saturday to actually continue home. But as I was on my way home, I got a phone call from 911 that my house was on fire, and I'm not going to go into all of the details of that right now. I may go into them later, but nobody was home. We did lose one pet, but like I said, it was probably by the grace of God that I got caught in that snowstorm, or I would have been here at home asleep and probably would have slept through most of what has occurred. I'm going to show you a little bit here on the outside. This was our main glass window. You can see where it's kind of falling in. You can see the attic above that, just below the roof line where the fire had traveled the whole length of the building. You can see around the edges of our new roof that we had just put on last year where the fire was kind of escaping out between the metal roof and the brick line. But if you would, I'm going to go ahead and take you on inside and invite you in and let you see what's happened on the interior. We're gonna go up the stairs here into the main part. The basement's too dark. I can't really get you into the basement at this time because of the smoke damage, the water. We still about have an inch of water sitting in our basement because the fire department, they had to put tons and tons of water into this place to actually stop the fire, and we actually had to call them back out because it reignited up there in the corner near the steeple. As I mentioned, the fire department thinks that the fire started down here in our loft area, which were the kids' rooms. And this is our bedroom over here, and this is where I would have been asleep. Because I hadn't been home in 2 weeks. I'd been home for less than 24 hours in 2 weeks. And this is actually where I would have been sound asleep when the fire broke out had I been home. But like I said, thank God nobody was at home. Faith lost a kitten that she had gotten just before Thanksgiving. Its name was Boots because of the new Puss in Boots movie. It looked like Puss. But take him down to this area down here. You can see where the chandeliers came crashing to the floor. I think this one here may be the one that's still stuck in the floor because these things have points. Yeah, I can't move it. This thing is solidly stuck in the floor from where it landed. I think we got another one over here too that's possibly stuck into the floor. But my antique table and buffet, it can be re-sanded, but it'd never be the same. You can see up here where the lights coming in from the windows that are all busted out. That point up there where you see light at the very top is just beneath what was the steeple area of the church. Over here, uh, over here was our living area. Something I haven't noticed before. Interesting. Our Fire Stick remote sitting on the arm of the couch where we last left it, evidently. It's kind of a neat thing. Crystal's karaoke system or PA system and all of our sound system, it's gone. This is as far as I'm going to kind of take you guys because I'm worried about structure. The structure's gotten actually worse over the past couple of days since we've been in here. I can actually see some settling and some shifting. And these beams, what you're looking at right now, those beams are the main support of the church. And I'm really concerned about the structure and the weight of that metal roof come crashing on down. But this is kind of the reason I haven't been on and haven't posted a video in the past
day or two. I'm going to show them the staircase.
We're going to actually take you in and show you the staircase real quick.
Our house was clean. It just doesn't look like it. There's all a couple years worth of prep food we had in there. That was all prep food.
Yeah, Crystal had done tremendous work in prepping, and like she just said, we probably had 2 years worth of food supply that we lost. It's not in here.
No. I've already checked.
Is that what it is?
I think he keeps that with him when he travels.
But yet the box is still good too.
There's something in here though. I don't know what's in here. Well, I can't tell what that is in here.
I don't know. Maybe he'll know.
How is there ceiling in?
Oh, that's strange, guys. I've got pieces of ceiling in Tyler's study Bible box. It's really interesting.
I think he keeps that with him when he travels. It's really hard to get up these stairs. I can't take you all the way up because you can see. I mean, it's
Crystal,
just.
Crystal, why don't you introduce yourself to the viewers so they know who you are?
Hey guys, I am Crystal Rose, Scott's wife. My daughter Faith is here with me. The stairs are actually hollowed out all through this area, so we can't go up any further. We could probably step here and be okay, but I'm really not about taking any chance. This is where they say the fire started, somewhere up here. My son and daughter, my daughter's half was way down there, and they had kind of like a divider area, and then my son's half was up here, larger than it looks. But they lost everything. We all lost everything, but you know, as a parent, you really don't care about what you have. You care about your kids. And you know, we're very blessed that everybody's alive and well, and things can be replaced. Nothing, you know, our treasures are not laid up here on this earth. And our treasures await for us in heaven, and our purpose is to do good deeds, and that's where, you know, that's what our mission is here on earth. So you could probably see, I could try to zoom in maybe, where it's starting to sag. I'm not sure how much longer. That's where the steeple used to be. I'm not sure how much longer this is going to be able to stay standing, but I'm going to bring y'all back down to Scott and let him finish out his video. He's not really wanting to come up these stairs, and I personally don't blame him. Yeah, I got it.
I'm not going to go up there. I mean, Crystal weighs a lot less than I do, and this whole structure is already very unstable, and I don't even know that we should be in here, to be honest, but so that's what we're going through. That's kind of where this channel's probably going to go for the time being. I wanted to kind of get y'all in on the ground level of it. because this journey is just now starting for us. Like I said, this happened Saturday. Today's Wednesday. And so I don't know what else I can say. I just ask y'all for your continued thoughts and prayers on what we're going through. Right now we're staying in a hotel. Christmas is coming up. That's out the window. We'll probably be spending it in a hotel. There's no rental properties nearby where we're at. So I don't know. Everything's just kind of up in the air right now. But guys, again, thank you. And if you would, subscribe and please share this video so I can get a little more followers to kind of join me on this video or on this journey, perhaps. It would be nice. But please share this video and just keep us in your thoughts and prayers. And until next time, keep your armor on.